Hello, this is Boaz Arberg, and today's presentation will be Robot Dynamics Single Link. We'll start with the real environment which is being analyzed. We'll take a look at the kinematic diagrams in 2D model. We'll define the coordinate system, the variable definitions, the problem definition, and then we'll see the graphical solution and the analytical solution. The robot that we're looking at is an articulated robot, and this is the robot model that we'll consider. We will analyze only one link. It has an inertial coordinate system, x0, y0, and a rotating coordinate system attached to the link itself, x1 and y1. The variables of this problem include the kinematic variables. You see here the angular position of the link with respect to coordinate system. It has an angular rotation omega, an angular acceleration alpha, and these arrows indicate the direction of the positive direction, which is in the z direction. Z0 and Z1 is the same line, and it's coming out of the screen. We also have the specification of the position vector from the pivot of rotation to the point where the gripper force is applied. This is denoted as R, and from the point of rotation to the center of gravity of the link, it's denoted as RCG. We also define the mass of the link and the moment of inertia, I. The definition of a problem here is to find the joint reaction of the link as a result of this motion, and also the motor torque which is required to generate the motion. The value of the reaction forces is needed to size the bearings of the robot, and the motor torque, of course, is to size the motor that is required to move this robot with this configuration. We are given numerical values for all the different parameters, and we have to watch out, for example, in the parameters, in the angular parameters, in the equation, they all have to be radian-based. So if we're given degrees, we'll have to convert that to radians. If we're given RPM for omega, it'll have to be converted to radians per second. Sometimes alpha is given as the time to reach maximum velocity. It still has to be converted to radians per second squared. We start the solution by looking at the equation of motion. The first equation, equilibrium of forces, so-called Newton equation, we see there are four forces: the gripper force, the base force, which are acting at the point of application of these forces, and at the pivot joints, and then we have inertial force acting at the CG and gravitational force acting at the CG. For the moments, we have the motor torque, we have the gripper torque, and then we have the moment on the CG. All moments are about the CG. The reason is that we want to eliminate the moments of the inertial force and the moments of the gravitational force. That's we will have to consider if we would take them about any other point. So the moment of the gripper about the CG is the radius vector from the CG to the point of application, and this vector here is equal to R, which is from here to here, minus RCG. So this minus this is exactly this, and we cross it with F gripper, and we get the torque. You see R minus RCG cross with the gripper. Then we have the torque that the base is acting on a CG, and that is equal to the radius vector from the CG to the point of application, and you see that this is in opposite direction to RCG. RCG is in this direction. That's why we have a minus sign here. We cross it with the base force and we get this moment. And finally, we have the inertial torque, and the sum of all of these torques is zero. To solve for the unknowns are the base force and the motor torque. We take the base force, we leave it on the left-hand side, and take everything else to the right-hand side with a minus sign. Similarly, we leave the motor torque on the left-hand side and take all the other ones to the right-hand side with a minus sign. Then we like to substitute the inertial term. You see we have F inertial here, and also Fg equals to M times G, mass times the acceleration of gravity. So we leave the minus sign here, and G is has a negative y component, as we see over here. As far as the inertial forces, we have a minus sign here, but the inertial force is minus the acceleration. That's why we have to change these signs to plus, and we replace this inertial force with mass times acceleration. This acceleration is tangential. This acceleration is centrifugal, and together they represent the inertial force. For the torques, we have the inertial torque over here, which we have to substitute instead of Ti. It's a minus Ti here, so we have to actually write minus I alpha, which is the inertial torque, and change the sign over here. Finally, what we have to do is to take all the elements which are described in inertial coordinate system, like the gripper and the mass. These are the only vectors which are described in inertial coordinate system, and convert them to the rotating coordinate system with the rotation matrix T from coordinate system 0 to coordinate system 1. And the reason is because in these equations, the vectors must all be represented in the same coordinate system. And if you have any vector which is represented for any reason in a different coordinate system, then we have to use the rotational matrix in order to bring it to the same coordinate system. So we have these, and we put them in the equation. And the last thing that we have to do here in preparation for the analysis is to find out what is the rotational matrix. Recall that the rotational matrix is consisting of cosine, the angle of rotation on a diagonal. We put on a diagonal 1 at the axis of rotation. We put 0 at the column and 0 at the row. And then the question is, what is the sign of the off-diagonal sign? And to find out whether the minus sign is up or down, what we have to do is look at the little sketch. We have x0, y0, x1, y1, and we're looking for transformation for coordinate system 0 to coordinate system 1. And this means that the axis 1, for example, the vector on axis 1 will consist of the x0 times the cosine angle, which is this much, plus, you see that projects in the same direction, the y0 projecting in the same direction with y times the sine of theta. So therefore, it will be a plus sign in this position and minus sign here. If you want to convert for some reason from coordinate system 1 to coordinate system 0, it will be the transpose of this conversion from 0 to 1, and the transpose is simply transposing these two signs, so the minus sign in this matrix will be up and the plus will be down. With that said, we could start with the graphical solution. Now, what I like to do before I start the graphical solution is to cut and paste from various locations, the kinematic diagram, and also all the numerical values plus the equations, put them in Excel spreadsheet, copy all the numerical values nicely to the spreadsheet, and then look at some meaningful values such as mg or such as m alpha rcg, and calculate them and get the values over here, and we could use these values then when we construct the diagram. So we calculated these values, so we can go now with these values to some CAD system and start putting the vectors on a diagram. So we're starting with the gripper force in the inertial coordinate system. The gripper force was, as we see here, minus 150 and 50. And since we have a minus sign here, we'll have to draw it as 150 in a positive x direction and 50 in a positive y direction. And the sum of this will be the gripper force from here to here. And this gripper force has a magnitude of 158. We can put this value over here, gripper force 158. Then we go to the second term. Second term also is in the inertial coordinate system in a y direction. It has a value over here of minus 343 and a minus here. So we have to put the 343 from here all the way up in a positive y direction. The third force is the tangential acceleration. It has plus sign, so we don't change direction, alpha cos r. So this we know is perpendicular to the radius vector. So we draw a 70 degree line. 70 was the angle of rotation in that particular view. And we construct also a perpendicular line to the 70. And from here, we can go with the magnitude of the tangential force, which is 157 in the negative direction. Then we have the centrifugal force, and that is 262 in a positive direction towards the center of rotation. So 262, we have the magnitude here, brings us over here. So this actually completes the summation of forces, and from the origin to this termination of the vector summation, we get the vector of the base force, and that is equal to 227, and we see that it has component in the inertial frame of 93 newtons in the y direction and plus 208 in the x direction. To find out the value of the torque, we realize that all the torques are actually along the z direction, so there won't be any other components, just watch for the sign. So we go and we put the gripper torque over here. The gripper torque was given to us here as minus 15, and it has a minus sign, so we put it over here with the proper sign, and we get 15. Then we have over here I alpha. We pick up the values from here, and it has a plus sign, but alpha was negative, so we get 330 newton meter. Then we have over here the vector r minus rg across the gripper force. And to do that, what we have to find first is the angle between them, because the cross product is the magnitude of each vector times the sine of the angle in between them. So the angle in between them, this vector r is along the 70 degree line, as the gripper force we find here is this line. The angle between them is 51.6. We put it over here, 51.6. We take the radian, and we get the component over here, which is minus 61.8 newton meter for the torque. And the last term over here that we have is RCG times F base. Again, we need to find, because it's cross product, we need to find the angle between the F base, which is this line here, and the radius is along the 70 degree line. The angle is 46, so we put over here in the Excel spreadsheet the 46, convert it to radian, and over here we get the cross product value, which is the component product times the sine of the angle, and it's minus 48. Then they all have their proper signs. We add them up and we get a total motor torque is 425.8 as a result of the graphical solution. If you look at the analytical solution using MathCAD, again, I like to start by cutting and paste the numerical values for the problem and also the equations. And then I convert all the numerical values to the proper terms in MathCAD. For example, the gripper force that we had was minus 150 and 50. We put it over here, but we add also the Z component, which is zero. We can find the absolute value using the norm operator. We could also put over here a similar way the angular velocity, 5 radians per second, a zero component in x and y, but the component is a plus, as you see over here, in a z direction. Once we fill them all up, including the matrix of transformation, as we saw earlier, we can go back to the equation and simply write them up algebraically. So f base equal to minus T01 times the gripper force and so on and so forth, and we get the components in the moving coordinate system. To find the components in the inertial frame, what we have to do is multiply times the transpose, as we saw earlier, of the transformation matrix, and we get the components of the base force in the zero coordinate system with the operation here. We do the similar thing for the motor torque. We take the equation over here, minus T gripper, minus T gripper. All of these components over here, we calculate them explicitly so we can check, see if they make sense. And we define them as ABC. And then the sum of that with the proper sign is minus T gripper minus this one, which is minus A plus B and C, give us the final result of the motor torque. So when we compare the two results, we see the motor torque here is minus 426 newton meter. In the graphical solution was minus 425.9 newton meter. The force of the base in the inertial coordinate system was 208.92, and then when we look at the graphical solution was 208.93. There were no decimals over here. So with that, we complete the presentation. In upcoming presentation, we will look at multiple link robot, but the procedure is going to be very similar. Over here, we use gripper force and gripper torque, and we solve for the base force and the motor torque. If there was another link over here, we will use exactly the same procedure, but instead of gripper force and gripper torque, we will use whatever we find out on this link, which was the base force and the motor torque. And the force that the this link will act on the next link will be exactly opposite in direction to the force that we found here, and similarly with the torque. With that, I'd like to thank you for listening, and until next time, have a good day. Thanks.